Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the React Breadcrumb component from SyncFusion. Using the React Breadcrumb, you can visualize a page's location within the hierarchical structure of a website and navigate to the appropriate pages easily. In this video, I am going to show you how to add a React Breadcrumb component to a React app, and then I will explain how to customize the breadcrumb item separators, enable navigation to the last item, set overflow modes, and set relative and absolute URLs to the breadcrumb component. Now, I am going to create my project with the help of the Create React App toolchain, which installs the latest version of React and React DOM and React scripts. I will view and edit my code using Visual Studio Code and view the output on one of the supported browsers. To create a new React project, I need to install Create React App globally on my machine using the command npm install -g create React App. As I have already installed it, I am skipping this step here. Now, let me create a new React project using the command create React App project name. I want to create a React app with TypeScript, so let me add -- template TypeScript to the existing command. And I named my project React Breadcrumb. This will create an empty React application with no SyncFusion packages. I will navigate to the newly created application folder. To start using the Breadcrumb component within this empty application, I install the SyncFusion React Navigations package and its subcomponent packages using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2react-navigations --save. Once the installation is complete, my application is ready. The first thing I need to do here is open the app.tsx file and import the breadcrumb component from the ej2 React Navigations package. Next, I will replace the default code and add the React breadcrumb component within the render method of the React component. Next, I open the index.tsx file and import register license from the SyncFusion EJ2 base package. Then, I register the SyncFusion React trial license key by using the register license method. The SyncFusion React license key registration is required from the 2022 Volume 1 release onward. Next, I need to define the CSS for the breadcrumb component. I can either import the React breadcrumb component CSS in the app.css file or reference the CDN link in the index.html file. To make it simple, I choose the second option. So, let me open the index.html file and reference the CDN link inside the head section, which includes the combined CSS references of all the essential JS2 React components. Next, I am going to run this example using the command npm start. Here, you can see the breadcrumb component rendered with the home icon. Next, I will show you how to add items to the component. To do that, let me define a breadcrumb items directive tag, which accepts n number of breadcrumb item directive definitions. I plan to add 5 items, so I add 5 breadcrumb item directive tags with appropriate text inside this breadcrumb code. Here, the breadcrumb items directive and breadcrumb item directive are automatically imported from SyncFusion EJ2 React Navigations to add the items in the breadcrumb component. Then, I will define URL property with appropriate path for these breadcrumb items. Here, I have set relative URL to the breadcrumb items. And now, you can see the breadcrumb component, defined items are shown here. Looking at the breadcrumb component, you can see it contains the path, but not its location. Next, I will show how the absolute URL works. Now, I am going to set absolute URLs for the items, so I will set absolute URL links to the URL property. Look at the output page now, on clicking the items, they navigate to the location path. Here, the URL link opens in the same page. If I want to open the link in a new page, then I use the before item render event. To do that, first, let me define the before item render event with an appropriate event handler. Then, I will define the open URL in new page method and set the target property of the anchor element for the required item to blank within this event handler. Now, on clicking the breadcrumb item, the defined URL opens in a new page. Notice here, by default, the breadcrumb last item navigation is disabled. If I want to enable it, then I set enable active item navigation as true within this breadcrumb code. See the output page, on clicking the last item, it navigates to the location path. Here, all the items are shown in the breadcrumb component. Suppose I want to limit the items, then I would use the max items property. Now, I am going to show 3 items in the component and hide the others, so let me set the max limit as 3 within this breadcrumb code. You can see in the component 3 items are shown and the other items are collapsed. While clicking ellipsis icon, the hidden items are shown. Next, I will show how to customize the separators with arrow icons. First, I will define the separator template event with an appropriate event handler. Then, I will define this method append arrow icon and return the span element with appropriate class names. Within this index.css file, I will define a font face with a specific src path and name its font family to start accessing the required font icons for this breadcrumb component at the application level. Then, I will assign the appropriate content values to access the needed font icons. Also, I have set few CSS styles for this breadcrumb component item separators. See the output page. The arrow icon is appended between the breadcrumb component items. Next, I will show you how to set overflow mode. The Syncfusion React breadcrumb component supports 6 types of overflow modes: collapsed, menu, wrap, scroll, hidden, and none. Here, I plan to wrap the breadcrumb component items to multiple lines, so I will define the overflow mode and set its value as wrap. Look at the output page now. The breadcrumb component items are wrapped to multiple lines when the breadcrumb's width exceeds the container space. Similarly, you can set the other overflow modes. By default, the navigation will be enabled when setting URL property. To prevent breadcrumb item navigation, set enable navigation property as false within this breadcrumb code. Look at the output page now. The item navigation is in disabled state. Let's recap what we have done in this video. We saw how to create a React app and added the Syncfusion React breadcrumb component to it. We saw how to customize the breadcrumb item separators, enable navigation to the last item, set overflow modes, and set relative and absolute URLs in the breadcrumb component. If you would like to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire React suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.